Hello everybody, welcome back to, of course I forgot the one thing I needed and I didn't think about that, but whatever. So, run back to base, grab our anvil, build some nails, and then start moving. Once we get these last few signs built as our tombstones to mark off our three deaths. I think we have three deaths, right? Yeah, three deaths. So, we got three deaths, not necessarily the end of the world, but we do what we do. So, mistakes happened in those three deaths, but whatever, shit happens. It was gonna happen regardless of whether we liked it or not, so. Probably could've just built a new forge over here, huh? Come on, so, shit. That was dumb. Gotta dodge all the spike traps. Which, unfortunately, this base is going to become obsolete for what I need to do next. Up on the roof, come on, stupid. Anvils, run back to base, build my nails, get the tombstones, and then actually start moving because I am a dumbass. Yes, I did. I have one anvil. Wow. Okay. Maybe that's why I brought it with, because I only have one. Stupid. Stupid ass. Of course I would. Of course this would be me. It's not me. It's not Midget if he doesn't fuck something up, right? Game? Physics? What? The fuck? How did that happen? I would understand almost anything except that. Okay, stop having an aneurysm. Put it on the block. Alright, you know what? I don't care where you put it, so I'm not here to worry about that. So, got our anvil. Why do I keep parking my bike so far away? So, like I mentioned at the end of last episode, we kind of need suggestions for long-term games. Obviously, first one comes to mind, Minecraft. You could do anything in Minecraft. But, I don't know. It's kind of iffy on Minecraft. It would be a nice learning experience, but that would also require me to go through and do... I don't know. Not that I have to do a whole hell of a lot, but it's just, you know, be learning a whole new game, basically. I do not, like, actually, it would kind of just be similar to how I started this series. I know a little bit of it, but I don't know a lot about it. Okay, can you just auto-equip in there? Yes. And let me jump over to the nails. And I'm not going to make that many. We're going to make, like, 30. Let's do 30. It doesn't take long to do nails, really, wow. Can I go to clay? I'm gonna go to clay face, I don't know. Okay, that's a lot. Take my nails here. Now, I probably need wood to make signs, huh? Let's see. Wood half block, don't need that. Wood sign 1 meter. Yeah, I'm just gonna make a few 1 meter signs. Actually, can I make. Was it maybe 10? Yeah, I'll do that. It'll take me probably just as long to get back to base. But now I have nails for my nail gun. Woohoo! I have nails for my. Oh, I'm spending all my nails on the signs, duh. I'm sitting here, I'm like, wait, I have ammo! But how do I not have ammo? Because my dumbass is picking the expensive signs. So, I don't know, still thinking of long-term games, and it's like, there's no games other than Minecraft right now that stick out in my head that I could play long-term. And when I say long-term, I mean, there's not really a plot. If there is, it's minimal. Like, I know Minecraft, the goal is survive slash defeat the Ender Dragon, which the only time I ever did that was when I actually went into creative mode, built the portal, and then said, fuck you, I'm doing it at this point. Okay, why are you down here? That makes even less logical sense than putting it up here, where you should be. Like, the two of you were literally supposed to just sit like this, and yet you couldn't even do that. Jesus. So, I don't know, it's kind of... While I could do Minecraft, don't really expect to fight the Ender Dragon, which maybe no one's expecting me to fight the Ender Dragon. So, I don't know. Alright, let's put... Oh, Jesus, the sign's huge. Alright, let's put our signs up as... I missed a chunk here? Yeah, whatever. Let's put it right there. Oh, lame. The dog was our first death. Oh, that's lame. Really? Do I have the symbols that I need to? Yes. Okay, let's go to that. Nope. Do that. Okay. It looks dumb, but you know what? There. Second death, we'll go here. Nope, hang on. Wrong button. I think that was the second death. It might have been the third death. Actually, yeah, that was the third death. The second death was radiation. I'm trying to remember the deaths, and it's like... There we go. Radiation's bad. Okay. If you understand that reference, good on you. Alright, then the third death was Don't Eat Glass. Right. This is a lot more effort than I thought it would be. Alright, hopefully we don't gotta add any more graves up here, because we're out of room. But, we have marked all of our graves with the things they needed to be marked with, so now we can move on to what I actually wanted to do. Which, do I have fuel? I need extra fuel around here. I need E to mean extra fuel. Let's see. Don't you guys gas barrels? Yeah, you are. Craft you guys down to some gas cans. Go 600 gas, but my goal is to drive to the west. Now you might be wondering why the fuck I have this plan to go west. Well, I mean, as much as Hollywood is to the west. No, that's not my, not that west. The west I mean is to a cave out here, to hopefully to a cave network, which if it is what I'm hoping it is, it'll be interesting. Since I know my luck and it probably won't be what I'm thinking it is, it's probably just gonna suck. So, I got my bullets, I got some fuel, let me see, oh, I have some gas in my car, okay, cool, my bike here, sweet, top her off, dump it there, and, yeah, I mean, realistically, my base is built, the final resting site for those three stupid asses who died before me, but... Now we go to the west, after I go get this drop. We'll grab the drop, then we'll start moving out. So you might be wondering why I'm picking going to a cave as, like, my final kind of send-off for the series. Well, I've never actually been in one of the caves in these games, so I kind of want to see if it's all that I've heard it to be. Now, you might also be thinking, well, we didn't really explore the winter biome all that much. We didn't really explore the desert biome, or the radiated biome, or whatever the hell you want to call it, no man's land. But to that, I'll say, fuck that. We're not totally built for that, so we're not gonna do that. And I think that's pretty fair. So, and as it is, you saw how much fun we had with the winter biome. I just realized I didn't eat anything before I left. Thick. Yeah. Okay, as much as I wanted it to be a final send-off... Okay, we can't see shit. I know this thing is this way. If a lumberjack shows up, then tough shit. Not dealing with them. Okay, rocket launcher stuff. We have a raw rocket launcher now. Awesome. Okay. I love how he just pulls that out so happy. Yeah. Let me read the thing on the spike club. Oh, I have Yuga for... Okay. That is fine, then. Alright, let me trade my axe over. Okay, we're undetected, which is good. Hop on my bike. I'll run back to base and get some food, but other than that, we're really not in need of anything. So, okay, look south. Alright, that might help us, so we don't die to radiation poisoning again. But, all in all, I just want to see what the cave has to offer, and if anything, if it sucks, it sucks. Alright, let me just try to chow down on a couple of these to get some sort of stomach so we're not dropping the overall, like, nutrition, or not the nutrition, but, like, the fucking stats down there, like, for our overall health, because I don't want to go losing that, because we'll need as much health as we can get. Depending on if this cave is what I think it is. If it is what I'm thinking it is, then we're in for a shitstorm. If it's not, which would be a nice change of pace to have it not be what I think it is, then we're not so bad. There's a camp over here? Okay, hang on. Let me get this real quick. Okay, fuck off. It was only you, so that's nice. Water, it's weird. Oh, wait, have I already been here? Nope, shit. I feel like I might have already been here. Still hunted by what? You, okay. Time to throw that in. My memory bank. Oh, now I know how to make leather leg armor. Awesome, thanks. The leather armor. It's always just been kind of like there. I've seriously been here? I don't remember this place at all. I really do not remember this place. Like, that's not even me trying to. Did I get that? Wow, shit. Okay. I did not know this place was here. Like, it caught me off guard that it's here, and yet apparently I've been here. Whatever. So yeah, I mean, having that rocket launcher is going to be nice. Send us off with a bang. So, I don't know, and I kind of want to... The trip over to there, I'm going to be kind of... Wow. Okay, this actually looks kind of cool. Driving up on it, like... If I had driven up on this place... Like, if this was already built... Long... Like, if there were actually NPCs that could... Like, raiders and all that shit... I would think this is a stronghold that I need to break into. In order to try and get something out of it, which, you know what, I wouldn't mess with this place. Not gonna lie. If I was a random, if I just day one booted up and found this place, nope. Fuck that. This place is clearly well defended. We don't need any of this. We're good. We're gonna say no to all that. But since I know who lives in this place, I think the guy should be alright with us. Just kind of coming in and eating some of his food and fucking up some of his shit. But I intend on just kind of maxing out my stats here. So, we're good. Come on. Oh, this is taking forever. Hydration is down, but whatever. So let's throw scrap you, put you in there. Rocket launcher is going to this chest, which is all my gun stuff. Alright, let me pull you out, put you in my inventory, and start. I just want to make sure I'm not, like, totally screwing over this base here, because if this base gets overrun and I really need to run away, odds are I'm not going to be making it back in time, so. Which I don't plan on coming back anyway, but. You know what? I might as well, like, leave a little for me to come back to if I need to. I don't want the 105, really. Yeah, that sucks. Alright, time to bring a bunch of canned food with me. So, let's bring a can of pasta. You guys just up in here. Don't need all these antibiotics, so we'll leave those there. Throw the dirt in here, because I'm not really coming back here. Bring the booze, because you never know. You really never know what's going to happen in the wasteland. Boop, boop. Probably don't need the bone chip anytime soon. Keep the yucca fruit on hand, just as a quick, easy, cheap food. Let's do that. Let's do this. And throw my lead in there too. Okay. So I think we're leaving with everything we really need and nothing we don't. So. The wood frames. I'm gonna lock the front door with the wood frames. But that will be the. Okay, this time, I swear this is the actual final send off for this fucking base. Tired of fucking having to come back to bases and shit. The hell? I didn't realize we were in, like, the middle of a bloody snowstorm. What the hell? We're not even on the seventh night. We're just out here. And yet... Okay. Weird. Okay, let's hop on our bike and get out of here, then. If this isn't a bad omen, I don't know what is. So, we are to go west. I believe... We haven't been over there yet, but my target is in, like, this general area. Had a map open, but I don't think I have it open. So we just gotta go west. We hit a main artery, and we'll go west. Like, once we get to the house, we pretty much follow that road through that little kind of discreet area, and we'll go from there. This is not towards the house in the slightest. How do I know? Because I just do. The house, I think, is like over this hill, isn't it? I'm already fucking lost. I've been gone out of the house for like 2 minutes. Where the hell am I going? I can't see anything. Oh, I'm just. Okay, so I gotta turn around. I'm on the road? Really? Okay. So I gotta go south. Oh, yeah, that might explain it. That might explain why I was kind of missing everything. Alright, so I need the road, which I am on. I just gotta follow it all the way down. Okay, I'm already off the road. Snowstorm really fucked up my bearings, but now I'm okay. Now I'm good. Now we're good. So we're just gonna go down this road here a little ways. We got 5 minutes left, so well, roughly 5 minutes left in this episode. So, but these next few episodes are gonna be a bit more kind of. It's gonna be a bit of a late game tutorial, but kind of also it'll be helpful for people that don't really know this game. Which is kind of funny how you picked the last 5 episodes to explain how to do good in the game, which... I mean, my 3 deaths were avoidable. I clearly played them ridiculously dumb. But, all in all, it is 100% possible to... Yeah, fuck you. Yeah. Oh, I didn't get stun damage on you, alright, jerk. But... It is completely possible to get to this point in the game, I mean, hell, 26 days in, and not have a death. I say it's possible, I just, given the way I play the game, it's a bit unlikely. Because my way can be a little bit risky, But it's also kind of like a high-risk, high-reward scenario. So it's kind of like you got to take it with a grain of salt, because the methods I take, I wouldn't start off by running into the cities. I would avoid the cities at all costs until you are actually well-equipped. Okay, stop making it all ominous and shit. It still feels like we're in the middle of the day here, like, I really don't need the headlight on. But the goal is to cut through the town, and then we're going to be cut through this little neighborhood here, and then we're going to go to the north. To the north! Yeah, no, not that far north, because, you know, we're not going to be on Season 8 here, but... I don't know, it's kind of like the first 7 days are... Like, your first 6 days are the days you really need to find a place to hold out, because you can't really build a place to hold out that early. If you're in creative mode, you can, but... Yeah, he's not open anymore. Did I mess up my split already? Am I not? Food. I saw a rabbit. There it is. I saw him. He's hiding in the grass. I'm getting my rabbit, damn it. I don't know where he went. I wanted to get that rabbit. Oh, shit. Back to the road. And there's the road. So, ooh, a pig. I still have my bone shiv, so I'm gonna take... You know what? When I get where I'm going, if there's a campfire that I can cook at, we have food. So, and it's not really doing anything harmful. This pig was gonna die anyway, whether it was a zombie attack or me. If it's me, you actually help something, whereas if you're helping a zombie, you're really doing everybody, so... Not the best course of action you want to take. And there we go. Just leave it as a carcass. But we'll put that meat in the trunk, so we are not drawing unnecessary attention to ourselves, because that is stupid. Fuck these large bones. They're useless. Alright, back on the road. But your first 6 days are... I would argue... I'm arguing against myself here a little bit, because your first 6 days are your most important, but you need to also be aware of the, you obviously need to not be so cautious. You can play, all I can hear is the song, you spin me around in my head while I see this pig in the tree. Because all I hear is just, watch out, here I come. Okay. God, I'm easily distracted. So, you know what, I'll go a little bit further in depth with my tutorial on how to survive better in the next few episodes. So, if you guys did enjoy, throw the YouTube stuff down below. It just shows you're helping out. Makes it so you support the content and all that good stuff. And if you got any ideas for games long term, Minecraft is on the table, but I'm open to anything else. And unfortunately, I might not be able to respond to the comments in like one of these videos, because I'm going to be recording a bulk of this. So I don't think I'm going to go through all episode 50, but probably another episode or two in this session. But if you guys do enjoy, do the stuff, but I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.